Take the crown, drag them down. Take the crown to show them how.
We're taking the crowns, break them down. Hang them on the bedroom wall. We're dancing with bloodhounds through the town. Banging on padlock doors. And we're singing like, oh, 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 oh. Save to the sinners, save to the sinners. And we're coming for you, oh.
For 21 years, Explosive Championship Wrestling has been the symbol of excellence in the backyard wrestling community. It's no secret that the best that the backyard has to offer will inevitably show up here. Even talent from halfway around the world can still make time to be at XCW. XCW really is the place to be. That is, unless EBW gets their way. Tonight, EBW have several chances to make up ground, and now they have the services of referee Aaron Schaffner to help do it. First, Tommy the Man Merriman, once the greatest enemy of the franchise player Chris Jones, now stands side by side with him to challenge Hunter Halkin, who will have the ever-zealous Corey Lee at his side. Can Corey instill enough fear into the young upstart to ensure victory, or will Tommy Merriman unplug the console permanently? Plus, Blady Branson has tried again and again to wrest the XCW Tag Team Championships away from the real ones. Tonight, he's chosen James Cerebral as his tag partner. Will tonight be EBW's night, or are the real ones just too sweet? Finally, Alex Cardona Thompson will be putting his XCW Championship on the line against the man who arguably cheated to win the chance 2 weeks ago, Miano Diaz. With Aaron Schaffner refereeing and with the match being contested under legacy rules, can ACT overcome the enormous odds stacked against him, or is Miano Diaz going to do the unthinkable and take the XCW Championship back to EBW? Find out the answers and more as Explosive Championship Wrestling presents Glory, the 21st Anniversary Show.
It's glory.
I need a drink.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. JJ, as always, with Aaron Blackheart here on the table, and here we are again. This will be our first full year, isn't it, together?
Yeah. That's weird to think about. At this time last year, I was, like, on the roster and wrestling and getting ready to put an end on everything. But now we're here tonight at our 21st anniversary. Don't get too drunk, though, because there's a lot of action coming your way, including that big, what the hell was the stipulation again on that title match? The
Legacy rounds?
Okay.
4 3-minute rounds.
This might be the first time I'm going to rely on you other than the other way around on the commentary booth. But ACT is going to defend the XCW Championship against Miano Diaz, who earned that right 2 weeks ago to take over the world under dubious circumstances, let's be honest.
It is what it is.
We got the tag titles on the line tonight, as we heard in the pre-show. The real ones are going to take on Brady Branson and James Cerebral in a tornado tag match. Oh, my God. If you saw Real Ones tornado tag match with Foundation back on Encounters, oh, man, that's not going to hold a candle to this one, I have a feeling.
I wish IMF could have sent those guys, but, hey, speedy recovery.
That's fine. Speedy recovery. Omen, yep. Soldier GP, thinking about you guys, hardcore.
That's how it goes, though.
But we're going to open this show with a hell of a match. Also, We already have it sitting at ringside. It's been looking at me like I'm 20 years older than I am. I'm going to be in there eventually. But it's a casket match.
Yes.
As Shane Shaw goes one-on-one with DJ Wolbert, and I'm done wasting time.
Let's get it started. Let's get it on!
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, your opening contest for glory, is a casket match! The only way to win is to throw your opponent in a casket and close the door. Introducing first, from Salem, weighing in at 135 pounds, he is DJ Wolbert! Casey, how long has it been since we've had a casket match? Have we ever?
Well, we have, but unfortunately it's been quite a while. We've had more trunk matches, I guess, than something similar, but...
I'd be easily heat fit.
DJ, that's pleasant as always.
And his opponent, from parts unknown, weighing in at 209 pounds, this is Shane Shaw!
Wow, man, after kind of screwing the proverbial pooch for DJ Wolbert.
Oh, yeah, he has some choice words about Shane Shaw.
I guess never say never, but I wouldn't count on it.
I would say never in this case, I think. Wow.
Okay.
Shane Shaw standing up to DJ Wolbert.
Finally.
Oh, wow.
Did you expect any less?
Shane Shaw symbolically throwing the unholy shirt right in DJ Wolbert's face, and they're going at it, folks. Oh, my God.
That's what I'm talking about. Coming out right now, ladies and gentlemen. Glory, we're kicking it off.
DJ Wolbert's got Shane Shaw in the corner with a big chop. The chops have been served already here tonight in St. Paul.
Yes,
big back
sir.
Elbow as well. And Shane Shaw moves out of the way.
Oh, look at this. Get some offense in here, ladies and gentlemen. He's going to have to do something big to get DJ Wolbert down here. Obviously, you know, you have to get put in the casket to win the match.
I used to feel bad for DJ, but the way he's treated Shane. I speak English sometimes. It's useful. But the way he's been treating Shane lately, I really hope Shane whips his ass.
I mean, that's how it goes.
Oh, big kick right there. Man, oh, man. And the only way to win this match is to throw your opponent in the casket, so this chair is completely legal. And thank God for that, because if anybody needs to be violated by that chair, it's DJ Wolbert.
The crowd is loving it. Oh, man, DJ getting hit with a chair a couple times. And like you said, Eric, everything is legal here. Use whatever you can to get your opponent in the casket.
What are those?
Balsa wood tied in? I don't even know. Something that's gonna hurt, that's for damn sure. He just pulled it off. I'm not even sure what the hell.
Wondering for weapons here.
I'm not even sure. Oh, uh-oh! obviously a lot of bad blood between these two.
They're beating the absolute hell out of each other.
Oh, it's personal, ladies and gentlemen.
It's been personal. What do you think, JJ? After the disillusion of the unholy, and oh my God, what a body splash!
The chair just floats away. Oh man!
Directly to the left of our broadcast position, JJ.
Yes, sir.
And they're heading towards the casket now. Here we go.
Big time crossbody. Can this be? He's got to get it in there, and he's got to shut it.
That lid is very heavy, and Shane Shaw gets a foot up, preventing the closure of the casket.
Oh, wait a minute.
Preventing it again.
Steve-O keeping a close eye. Remember, he has to close it completely.
Yep, it's got to be completely closed. Oh, my God, just wrenched that leg around the edge of that casket. Good Lord. That's like oak. Maple, maybe? That's strong wood. That hurts. The crowd getting behind Shane Shaw.
Is he going to be able to come up against DJ Wahlberg? Oh, buddy!
Oh, my God! Head first goes DJ into the pole. Where the hell are they going,
okay.
JJ?
I don't know. They're going up into the crowd.
Do we have to follow them?
I don't think so.
God.
I think if they go
outside. I feel safer back here behind the table with you.
If they leave the arena, we do, unfortunately. But I hope they
don't. I don't think they're going to leave the arena. I hope not. That would be silly. The casket's here.
Yeah, so far so good.
They're brawling into the XCW Galaxy's getting a nice little up close and personal view. Oh, my God. Neckbreaker in the stands.
Right onto that. Those sturdy maple bleachers up there. And just continuing to waylay on Shane Shaw over here.
The fans are getting it up close and personal. This close in the stands? Are you kidding? Oh my God! This close in the stands!
Christ almighty!
These two are gonna kill each other. And they might be the only way you can get one of these two into the casket, JJ.
That's what DJ said he was gonna do, and I guess he meant it.
Good Lord.
It is personal. DJ always making it personal. This time no different as he's climbing up the stands here.
What is he doing?
Oh, he's trying to slide down the rail and get Shane Shaw.
He's got that balsa wood. I almost thought there was like stuff sticking out of that, but no, that's just straight up. It's going to hurt no matter what.
Yeah, taped on up together. Oh!
The fact that they had to, oh my God! That's a gunshot.
Right on in there, ladies and gentlemen.
To keep that stuff together, that's good wood.
Oh, you're telling me. Oh, buddy.
My God, is that. I've never heard the crowd more behind Shane Shaw in my life than right now.
Holy
And probably
crap.
For good reason, too.
Oh, man.
Shane Shaw setting up these chairs in the ring, setting up a... What is he doing here? Oh, my God. It's like a makeshift table with these balsa wood.
A mini little, yeah. But, hey.
That's going to hurt.
Whatever works. You just got to make sure.
Oh, my God. Oh!
There we go. Yeah, buddy.
Crunch.
Right into it, and it snaps in half.
Even though those are like small, that still could not have felt good. Not in the slightest. Oh! Chair to the ankle. Oh! DJ ain't gonna be haunting no graveyards on one foot, I'll tell you that.
Oh, man,
good
DJ.
Good God.
He's gonna have to make something happen here.
I saw Steve-O wins. Look at that. Not again. Not on that. Oh, I thought it was going to happen again. DJ blocks the suplex. Look at this. Going. Oh, my God. Going for that deadly. Oh, there it is. Deadly driver there by DJ Wahlberg.
Uh-oh. Coming from behind here, DJ Wahlberg.
But remember, pinfalls, submissions, they don't matter. You got to get your opponent in the casket, and you got to shut that door. That's the only way you can win this match.
Shane Shaw trying to get the crowd behind him, and I'd say so.
Look at that absolutely demented look on DJ Wolburn's face. He knows what he's going to do to Shane Shaw.
He's ready to hit him again.
And it sickens me. What is this? Oh, that's gonna hurt. That's thumbtacks in that. That's thumbtacks in that. There's thumbtacks in the end of that. Oh my God!
Oh, buddy!
Gonna oh my some, God! He's ripping flesh with that.
Gonna give him some nasty splinters there.
I'm gonna be sick. And now the chair being set up. DJ threatening to go out and beat everybody up in the audience.
DJ yelling at the crowd as he's kind of taking a siesta here.
My God.
Sizing up Shane Shaw. And
I don't think he should be jaw-jacking. I think he needs to concentrate on Shane Shaw. One, Shane Shaw's not to be taken lightly, as we saw.
One has to wonder if
did you see his match with Jackson Law and Vortex last week? My God.
Oh, I did.
Those two people got better each other, too. My God, what a chair shot.
Yeah, and if you haven't seen Vortex yet, what are you doing, ladies and gentlemen?
Yeah, if you haven't seen Vortex yet, and you haven't seen that match with Jackson Law and Shane Shaw, my God, what a match that was. One of the best matches I've ever seen in Shane Shaw's career.
Go watch that. Go watch the Hall of Fame ceremony. We inducted those, three in.
Those two ate a lot of shit in that match.
Oh, man, ladies and gentlemen, continuing the action here.
What is that? Is that like a painting canvas?
Looks like it.
Like an oil painting?
That's a work of art!
Oh my God!
There we go! Yes, sir!
Jesus!
Right through the Monet, oh man!
I think we gotta take another look at that stunner there. My God, Jesse Justice would be proud.
Big!
Beautiful maneuver sends DJ Wolver back first through that oil painting and back to live as Shane Shaw just broke that balsa wood right over that ankle that Shane Shaw's wisely been working this whole match.
You might as well.
Oh, Lord. He's trying to make sure DJ can't walk, can't go up top for his patented nail in the coffin.
Yes, sir.
If you break an ankle, you're not going to climb, that's for sure.
No, sir. He's not messing around today. That is for damn sure.
I'm having deja vu. Another balsa wood. That one, that was the one with the thumbtacks in it. I see the thumbtacks from here. They're laying on that gray chair.
Oh, yeah, there they are.
DJ with a jawbreaker. Going to try to suplex Shane Shaw.
Oh, who's gonna come out here?
Shaw,
who's going to do it?
Shaw, fight back. Oh. DJ, fight back now. They're fighting over the suplex. Who's going to go through this?
Oh, there we go.
Good Lord.
Shane Shaw and DJ both going through it there.
I cannot tell if that snap was that balsa wood or if it was Shane Shaw.
Let's hope it was the wood.
Good God Almighty.
Oh man, Shane Shaw. First to his feet here, he's making this a hell of a contest. Definitely not as easy as DJ Wolver would have liked.
This is the opening contest, JJ.
Yes,
this is
yes.
The first match.
Yes,
it
is.
An anniversary show.
Hey, we got to start off the 21st season right, ladies and gentlemen. This is definitely the way to do it.
What in the world is this? Oh, that was going to be an inverted suplex. No, oh, it's Shane first again.
Oh, he goes
Shane.
For it. But unfortunately, DJ unable to come down. Mother, oh. Man, Shane Shaw, that's what he needed. He might be able to come out with it here.
DJ tried to hit the graveyard condition, and Shane blocked it. Oh, my God, he hits one of his own.
Man, DJ laid out here.
But can he get him into the casket? That's the whole point. He's got to get him over there into the open casket.
Shane Shaw really coming to his own, and this would help continue the story here, putting down his mentor, DJ Wolbert. The man who said DJ created him. Like he's some kind of mad scientist. Oh! Uh-oh.
Big rose plant there by DJ. Now DJ gonna go up top. Possibly to try to put the nail in the coffin. Well, he's
gotta
do it literally tonight. He's gotta do it literally. This isn't gonna finish him. Oh my God!
Yes!
Just nails him. And now he's gotta try to roll him over to put him into that casket.
Uh-oh, and he's throwing him right into it, but he's got to cross the lead. Is Shane Shaw going to be able to fight out? Or is this the end of Shane Shaw?
He's just trying to, he's not just trying to close, he's trying to bury him.
I think this may be it. Eric, no, say it ain't so!
The winner of this match! But unfortunately for him, DJ Wolbert was just too much to overcome. My God. How are we going to top that? Well, we got to stick around to find out as Glory, the 21st anniversary of XCW, continues next.
Fucking game. This is XCW. We don't play this shit around here. I'm over your fucking bullshit, man. You know what? That's it. Tonight, me and you, one-on-one.
One-on-one?
For this.
With me.
Get the fuck out of here.
You get the fuck out of here.
This is my house. Get to seven.
You get to seven.
This about? Come on, man. Jesus Christ.
My God.
Okay.
Well, it was supposed to be Fletch and Milo, but Milo just took Fletch out.
The young upstart there. Okay.
Can't believe this. Well, Brogan's stepping in there. Thank God for him. We're going to have an XCW Hardcore Championship match tonight as Brogan O'Shea defends against Milo Malice. Like, bless Milo you. Deserves it, but, you know, stranger things have happened.
I just work here, man.
It's ridiculous.
Hey, it's going to be good. The young upstart getting to prove himself. Let's see what he's got, all right? Let's see what he's got. It is what it is.
Anyway, New Age title is about to be on the line as Evan Phoenix goes head-to-head with Jay Ellis. Let's get right to that right now.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the XCW New Age Championship. Weighing in at 255 pounds from Brisbane, he is the XCW New Age Champion, Evan Phoenix. He's got one win under his belt. Technically.
A win's a win.
A win is a win no matter how you view it, yes. But I'm sure Evan Phoenix would like to actually win the match instead of just having to handle it by this year.
Yeah, you heard. He's ready.
I'm sure he would prefer that.
He's ready to prove himself, win that lucky seven, and hopefully the international title.
That's his goal.
Okay.
If it ain't about the money, don't involve me.
That's not, unfortunately.
It is about the New Age title, though, so I'm sure Jay's happy to be involved for this. That's a hell of a prize. Seven victories to an international championship shot.
100%, Jay, unfortunately, had the international title and lost. get it back. Of course, like you said, you got to get the 7 wins, though.
That's true. To be held away for Jay to kick off the 21st season. Be held away for Jay to kick off the 21st season by winning the New Age Championship, though. Evan Phoenix is going to do what he can to prevent that from happening. Festus Davis showing off what it's all about, the New Age title.
Yes, sir. All on the line tonight. Evan trying to win, like you said, his second one. And ladies and gentlemen, here we are. The 10-minute timer has started. The match is underway. And let's see if Evan Phoenix can get a second win under his belt.
Jay's already discarded the mouth guard. They landed out here next to our cameraman.
Hey, that's just how serious he is out here, okay? He's already started off right.
Hey, when the title's on the line, all bets are off.
It's like he's going for the Phoenix driver early.
Nice little back and forth. Nice little back and forth there from Jay and Evan.
Yes, sir, but let's see if he's going to be able to capitalize here.
Listen, these two are on pretty friendly terms, so I don't know if there's any real bad blood here, but with the New Age title being on the line, you know they're going to give their all.
Somebody's got to win, though, Eric. That's just how it goes.
Evan Phoenix backing Jay Ellis into the corner. I expect a clean break here from Evan Phoenix.
Festus.
He's not going to do that to Jay.
No, see, he got a 3. Didn't even go to the 4. Not even close to a 5, you know. That's good to see.
He's a superhero. Superheroes don't cheat.
Have you seen the Evan Phoenix? I don't know about that.
He wasn't a superhero then.
Okay, yeah, true.
Supervillain, maybe. I'll give you that.
Yeah, right. Got to have a redemption arc here. As it's been about a minute into the contest. A little more, a minute and a half. And the action's still heating up here, just getting started. Each competitor.
I haven't been doing this as long as you have, so you have to give me some slack.
Yes, sir. I believe if it goes to the 10 minutes, Evan Phoenix still retains.
Evan doesn't even have to beat Jay, he just has to last the time limit.
Yeah, Jay
and
would
it would count as a win for him.
Yeah, Jay would have to be out in the 10 minutes.
Jay moved out of the way of that hip attack, and Evan got nothing but turnbuckle there, and I think he's really feeling it. Look at this. Jay with a big turnbuckle into the corner.
We've seen that before.
Yep. He's done that several times.
Yes,
Jay
sir.
Pulling him back up. Evan might have hurt himself on that turnbuckle a lot more than I thought. A little ginger to move there. Jay comes in with a hustle and the flow. Got tripped over a chair that was laying out here, a remnant from the casket match.
Yeah, but don't worry, he didn't use it. It's okay.
Jay said, F that S. Get out of my way. I'm being PG as I can.
That's just how it goes, my man. That's just how it goes.
Somebody commented that I said the F word at the end of Takeover the World. And I'm like, well, did you see who I used it against?
This is a family show, Eric. This is a family show.
Not when Aaron Schaffner did what he did. He deserved every bit of that.
Don't talk about that. It's still fresh.
It's a fresh wound. We'll have to talk about it at some point. XCW title is on the line tonight in the main event.
Oh!
Legacy rules, ACT and Miano Diaz. That's still to come.
Sir,
side headlock by Jay.
I'm interested to see that how those rounds go, ladies and gentlemen. See who comes out on top of the XCW title is Jay.
I just find that confusing, I'll be honest.
Hey, it's okay. I got it, Grandpa. Don't worry.
That's good. I'm glad one of us does.
No worries. It's Jay Ellis brought to his knees here. I thought he had him in the...
Also still to come, that big tornado tag title match as the real ones defend against EBW's James Cerebral and Brady Branson. That's going to be a hell of a match. Like I said, if you saw Real Ones match against the Foundation a couple weeks ago on Encounters, they tore the house down, almost literally. They beat the absolute piss out of each other. What is this?
Patrick O'Reilly.
What is this?
Coming in here, the match is over.
And yet again, Evan Phoenix gets handed a DQ win. That's ridiculous. Evan's frustrated too.
I think he's just happy to have 2 wins, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, Pat, listen, we're not gonna do this. We're not doing this. We're not ending this now. Because see, You have no right doing that. Because the only way you pull around here is your stomach.
Damn.
So you have no right to interfere with a match. And these people deserve a match.
We
so
do.
Get in here so I can beat your ass.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I'll put
Hell
the
yeah.
New Age on the line.
Evan Phoenix straight up.
Hell yeah.
Straight up feels disrespected by Patrick O'Reilly and is now challenged him to a match here.
He did cost Evan the, I mean, I guess it cost him the match, but, you know, handed him the match, so to
speak. He did hand him the match, and he cost Jay Ellis.
Yeah, ref Steve-O helps Jay out here is, I guess we're going to get back underway here, another match.
New Age title on the line again. Now Evan has two wins under his belt.
Yes, sir, that's two. Could he make it three right here, ladies and gentlemen?
He very well could. He very well could.
Starting us off here, checking on our competitors. The timer begins. 10-minute countdown is on as these guys sizing each other up.
And Evan Phoenix already starting off. Throwing Patrick O'Reilly into the cover. Already?
He's trying to end things quick, ladies and gentlemen.
Here's the cover. One, two. Oh.
I thought
Pat was going to regret taking the match there for a minute. Evan Phoenix almost had him beat right away.
Well, hey, that's just how it goes sometimes. We've seen it happen. We've seen it happen to Patrick O'Reilly.
Well, Patrick
Cash O'Reilly
in
and get destroyed.
Successful in winning the EBW title 2 weeks ago.
No. Unfortunately, Brogan O'Shea losing that.
Yeah.
He still has a hardcore title, though.
That's the weird. I still find that weird. Jackson Law is the EBW champion. We'll see him in action later.
Yep. Winning that Money in the Bank cash in.
Yeah. I would have picked a better use of the cash in myself. I wasn't Money in the Bank, so I can't talk.
I was thinking the same thing. Maybe he thinks he can't be AC.
I've never even been in a Money in the Bank ladder match, so.
But regardless, Patrick O'Reilly, a two-time New Age champion, looking to make it a third here.
And I think
not looking good though.
For a drive-by here.
Yeah, not looking good here. Evan Phoenix trying
right across the jaw.
Evan Phoenix trying to pick up his third win.
Beautiful drive-by.
Ooh, almost a three count as we're approaching the two-minute mark here. We still have 8 minutes left in the contest. It's been about 2 minutes so far, and still Evan Phoenix
I was able to, peer over still photographer's shoulders. He took a shot of that. It was a beautiful shot. I can't wait for y'all to see it on the Instagram.
Oh, yeah, that beautiful XCW Instagram, ladies and gentlemen. We're on
that'd
all
be XCW Shelbyville on Instagram, as well as on TikTok.
Facebook,
XCW Shelbyville. We're on Twitter at XD Wrestling.
Oh, wait a minute, Jay Ellis!
And here comes Jay Ellis! Jay Ellis gonna toss Patrick O'Reilly the match! Evan Phoenix is going to get to an international title match without even having to win once.
Listen, got you all set up tonight, right? You, Tommy Merriman. Listen, I know you can beat him. I've beat him countless times, okay? If I can beat him, you can beat him. You got to get out of your head, and you just got to listen to what I tell you.
Yes, sir.
Do you get it?
Yes, sir, I do. Sir, I do.
It's time to quit messing up. It's time to lock it in. You want to be a future world champion?
Yes, sir.
You want to have that belt around your waist?
Yes, sir.
Then you need to fucking pay attention when you go out there, and you need to put them in the ground. You understand me? No mercy. Absolutely zero.
Yes, sir. No mercy.
And don't worry, because tonight I have something special planned for myself, and I think you'll enjoy it too. You have a lot of fun with it, okay? But before that happens, your match happens, okay? But when I go out there and do what I need to do tonight, I want you to stay back, and I want you to watch how it gets done. You understand me?
Why do you want me in the back? I could be out there helping you.
I don't need you out there, okay? Just watch and pay attention. One day I won't even be out there with you. You understand me? So you need to know how to get it done. Just watch.
Yes, sir.
punished.
No, text back, call back. Dude, I've been trying to reach out for weeks. It's like, what, we had nothing? Like, you're over here following Corey around like he's got you on a little leash. Is that really who you want to be? You want to be Corey? I'm telling you, bro, he's bad news. Bad news. You need to watch your back. And you know where to find me.
Hardcore, there's nothing that Steve-O can do. Oh, Milo goes right head first into that explosion.
Oracle.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen.
DDT instead. I thought he was going for the last company into DDT. Yes, could still be enough, though. Cover one, two, and no.
Close, but no cigar. Milo finally into the canvas here as Brogan gets some offense.
Yeah, but look what it had to take. Took him getting hit with an exposed turnbuckle in order to take him down. That says a lot about the resolve and the strength of Milo Malice. Oh my God, what a back body drop. Good Lord.
Making it look easy.
There's high ceilings here in the St. Paul gym, but I think Brogan just touched him with his feet.
He's trying to kill Brogan O'Shea here.
Better men than him have tried.
That's true.
Brady Branson tried. I wouldn't exactly call Brady Branson a better man, but he has tried.
Yeah, Brady, Chris.
This is the only competition I have here.
Ooh. Killed Fletch, now he's trying to take that. Well, hey, he hasn't won yet, you know. Maybe he shouldn't talk that smack quite yet.
I mean, he did beat the hell out of Fletch.
Yeah, but he hasn't pinned the hardcore champion yet.
Not yet. But the way things are going, it's only a matter of time. Brogan is able to take back control with his knuckles.
Don't count Brogan out.
Big sledgehammer to the head. And now Brogan O'Shea can capitalize here.
Let's see. Yeah, I'm about to say, holding tight to the hardcore champion after hardcore championship. Losing the EBW championship.
You've been hanging out with me too long, it seems.
You're telling me, man.
Big scissors kick there by Brogan O'Shea. Could that be enough?
Right to the head.
Here's
here.
The cover. Hardcore John won the line, to Lando!
Close, but damn. Almost got him there, Milo. Kicks out at the last second there, unable to...
I don't think anybody can deny that Milo Malice is a tough individual.
Oh, not at all, not at all. Not easy to stand toe-to-toe with Brogan O'Shea. Unfortunately, he's let Brogan come back. He may not be able to come back from this.
Look at this, Milo reverses the suplex into one of his own. Brogan, I think, was going to cinch up there to try to do the three-leaf clover, which is going to be very difficult to do on somebody of Milo Malice's size.
You're telling me, maybe, no. Can't believe he can do it once. The crowd not a fan of Milo.
Let him have it. Milo Malice picking Brogan O'Shea's husk up off the mat, off the ropes. And a big thumbs pressed by Brogan O'Shea.
Look at
He's
that.
Trying to get back into it here.
Just takes him down, mounts him up, and oh, buddy, here we go. This is going to be good.
It's a birdie on course 7. He's putting for eagle. Oh, my God. Just sinks it. That's a 3-iron, I believe, JJ. At least that's what I think that's what that chair is made out of.
I don't know. Are we talking golf clubs? That's the only 3-iron I know.
Big drop kick there by Brogan O'Shea. Do I gotta spell it out for you, JJ?
I think so.
I eat the right G-O-L-F.
Oh, golf! I see what you're saying. Brogan O'Shea back in the action here, ladies and gentlemen.
Backing Milo into the corner. That chair going to come back into play again.
Showing why he's hardcore champion.
Wow.
Oh, here.
Hitting right in the stomach.
Here, here. Hold this for me.
Oh!
Christ almighty.
Serve that up on a grand slam.
Oh, there's Fletch though. Hang on. He's looking to the ring.
Yeah, I don't know. This is not why. I don't think this is wise.
I don't think he's going to be much
help. There's nothing that the ref can do. This is a hardcore title match. Fletch is injured.
But maybe this is just what Brogan O'Shea needs here.
Took Fletch down, but Brogan O'Shea, Milo turned his attention away from the middle for 1 second. Black Cole slam by Milo Malice, cover, hardcore championship on the line.
Oh, what? Wait a minute, are you serious? Brogan O'Shea on a losing streak. I never thought I'd see it. What is happening?
The winner of this match, by one of the pinfall. Champion, Milo Malice!
He's right. The only person in XCW currently that had more success this early was Eric Mason when he won the New Age title on his very first match. Milo Malice winning the Hardcore title on his second ever Big Show card match. Wow. And Flex, still injured, still hurting, helping Brogan O'Shea to his feet. We'd love to see that.
This could be the beginning of a long reign here. I don't like it either.
Look at this. A little show of respect and a handshake there. Fletch and Brogan O'Shea seem to be on the same page. Well, ladies and gentlemen, despite everything, Milo Malice is now the XCW Hardcore Champion, and we've got more glory to come. Stay with us.
Nobody expected what happened last week. Ever since you started in XCW, people have been counting you out. That's why when I came back, I said I had four targets. You were target number one, and that was to help elevate you to the position you are. I came back, you were never in a main event, never had a world title match, and look at you now. You literally last week beat someone who beat me and have an opportunity tonight for that XCW championship. Now, people didn't expect what happened last week. What do you think, man?
7 years I spent in this company. 7 years. And what did it get me?
It didn't get you nothing.
I lost my senior referee position.
You got that. You got beat up by me.
I've been blasted in the nose I don't know how many times.
Countless.
And this is the first time I've ever felt like I'm part of a family. Like I'm part of a brotherhood.
EBW is a brotherhood.
Plus the pay's good.
Pay is good. And we got big titty bitches.
That's where it's at.
So tonight, we're gonna go out there and do exactly what we did last week. You're gonna call the match right down the middle, just like last show, and you're finally gonna take the spot you deserve. Patrick O'Reilly held you down, you know, all the fans held you down. They've been booing you, and you've been proving every single person wrong. That's why I picked you over everybody. Picked you over Brady, picked you over Hayden, picked you over Tom, anybody I had my pick of the litter. I chose you for a specific reason. And tonight, you're going to go out and prove why you deserve to be XCW champion.
That's right.
And that's because you are the face of EBW, the fucking sauce, Miano Diaz.
Yeah.
Let's go get ready, guys.
Woo.
Close my door.
All right. Yes, sir.
The following matchup, scheduled for one fall, is for the EBW Championship. I didn't wanna wake up. I miss the misery. Introducing the challenger from Mesa, Arizona, weighing in at 250 pounds, Jesse Johnson. Interrupted in his match by Jackson Law. Jackson Law later on tried to cash in on ACT, and Jesse prevented that. They had a match 2 weeks ago at Top Takeover the World, but nothing has been solved. And now Jackson is EBW champion by way of his cash in. And they title Jesse Justice has never held, and he might hold it tonight if he can be successful.
One of all but that. I mean, I guess he's right, actually.
And his opponent from Indianapolis, Indiana, weighing in at 320 pounds, he is the EBW champion, the law of the land, Jackson Law.
Oh, buddy, after an exciting cash-in, definitely expected to cash in on the EBW title. He won. There he is.
He did. He won. He's got the belt. It's there. It's his hands to prove it.
Yeah, EBW.
It's tangible. It happened. Don't understand the point, but
mean, I'm sure he has a plan.
I think it's the orange.
Let's see. It matches his gear.
It's the only logical choice. For the, you gotta do it for the drip. You got to. Let's see if you can hold on to it.
There's worse reasons to do it.
The only reason to do it.
Jackson Hall throwing his sunglasses right at the camera. That's expensive. It's not the sunglasses. Those are dollars for sunglasses, but our cameras are expensive.
I wonder how much a year he spends on sunglasses. Do they break every time? Does he lose them?
Probably.
Are they the same pair? I need answers. We need to bring back...
He buys sunglasses like most people buy groceries.
That's what I'm saying, dude. We need a special one-time episode. Chris Jones, where you at? Interview Jackson Hall. I need to know.
Nah, he's done with that.
Yeah, I think he is too. Free time interview though, maybe?
I'm sure he's just as confused as everybody else as to why Jackson Law chose the EBW Championship. Again, I'm sure there's a big plan, but I don't know what it is.
I mean, regardless, still EBW doesn't have the championship, and that's
fair.
That's okay.
Yeah.
That's okay.
There's certainly worse choices to hold it.
Just kidding, Jackson Law.
No!
I said all that. Why have a ring announcer if he's just going to do it himself?
That's what I'm saying. I think you did a great job, Eric. A great job.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Hey, no problem.
Kill me. EBW title on the line. Beautiful orange belt paid for with Luke Blaze's money.
It's always better with someone else's money, isn't it?
I'm just glad Luke Blaze's money is going to so much waste.
Contest of strength. I don't know if this is such a good idea here.
Jackson literally has to hunch over to do this Texas trick. Like, we all know who the bigger person is here. I don't mean in terms of character. I mean in terms of size.
Oh, but see, look at that, though. Size doesn't always matter.
Yeah, it's right? Not the size that counts. It's how you use it.
You're damn right. Jesse Justice using it well there. Getting Jackson in the leg lock early here, holding it in, and oh! Smashing the ankle.
Working that ankle, my God.
Good maneuver there by the veteran Jesse Justice. Jackson Law, a veteran himself and other promotions and such. Relatively new to XCW, but still, hey, he's XCW EBW champion. Oof,
yes,
my bad there. Many wishes he was XCW champion.
I do find it, yeah, I do find it funny that half the commentary team has been XDW champion and he hasn't.
Yes, which half though? Which half?
Yeah, I'll leave that for you to figure out.
I am undefeated at Summer Mania. It's true.
Listen, people can't afford the tie to wash your damn jacket. Just keep it.
Are we going to have a wrestling match? We're just going to take our clothes off.
Smells like bacon anyway.
I think that's a medical condition. I don't think that's good.
Finally.
Thank God. Holy sh.
Oh! That'll take your arm out of its socket.
Jackson Law not happy to be back in action here, is getting his arm wrenched.
Jackson moves out of the way.
Surprisingly quick there.
Head of steam. Oh! Big body splash into the corner and a big bulldog to boot.
Oh!
Somewhere Brogan O'Shea is like, I could do it better.
You have to say he's.
Cover!
Looking on
nice.
At that orange
good
title
eye.
With tears in his eyes. I'm
good sure. Eye by Vestas Davis. He's only got one working one left.
I don't think it works that well.
I mean, it's kind of milky.
Oh! A little bit of a little payback there, working on the ankle of Jesse Justice now. Jesse,
I think he was just DDTing the foot just because he used the foot to break the pinfall.
I mean, why not? I mean, hell.
I mean...
Man, really locked, going in on that ankle there.
He is the law of the land, and he's thought of dumber reasons to punish people. Yeah. Look at this.
Hey, Tommy did stab somebody, allegedly.
He paid for his crimes. Not that I'm siding with him.
Did he, though?
He's EBW, so.
Hey, it is what it is. Obviously, Jesse Justice.
I don't know. I'd rather, if I was going to go to jail or go to EBW, I think I'd go to jail.
Yeah. I've been to jail. Yeah. I go to jail.
It's less likely to get pounded in the butt.
Wait a minute.
Jackson Law getting backed up onto that bottom rope.
The shoe is on the other foot, so to speak, as Jesse Justice back in control here. These two just kind of trained it off.
Shoes on the other foot. I mean, don't say that. Jesse Justice has trouble keeping the shoes on his feet. Oh, my God. Oh.
He didn't know which way to go there. He's up and down, up and down.
That jawbreaker just gave Jesse Justice a whiplash and a big basement drop kick right to the knees.
There goes his shin. See ya.
And now Jackson Law firmly in control here. Big senton. Big boy senton.
If his ankles weren't hurt.
Another big boy splash there by Jackson Law. EBW title on the line. Here's the cover. Two and no.
This is a problem for Jesse Justice. He is getting waylaid on. Oh, but he's got something in mind, it looks like here. Oh!
A shot to the kidneys.
A quick one. I saw that. I saw that. Bestis did. We saw that.
Yeah. I don't think a kidney punch is necessarily illegal.
Oh, okay. I thought he closed fisted him. My bad.
No, he just punched him in the kidneys, which, believe me, hurts. It hurts a lot. That's how you pee.
Thank you for that biology lesson.
Yes. Biology with Blackheart. That's a course I offer on TED Talks.
Coming XCW this summer, biology with Blackheart. Festus trying to get things under control here.
That was Jesse right in the eye. He's not going to be able to watch my TED Talk now. Oh, come on! That's ridiculous.
That's another one there. Come on now. Uh-oh, Ref Festus yelling at him a little bit, saying he'll just...
Jesse able to move out of the way of that one. Jackson Law caught nothing but turnbuckle, and now is in this sleeper hold type maneuver, the chicken wing. Look at this.
He's really locking it in there. He's got a lot of things going on here.
He's got it locked in deep. Could be moments away from capturing his first EBW championship. If the hand drops three times, it's over for Jackson Law. No, he kept it on the mat.
Oh, wait a minute.
Cover. Jesse able to get his shoulder up, thankfully.
Jesse trying to win an EBW. That's the only championship he's never had since the EBW title, newly introduced by Chris Jones last year. Miano, obviously the first recipient of that.
Not only is he the first recipient, he's the only EBW guy to have it.
Yes, very true. Brogan won it, held on to it until...
You gotta wonder if EBW's kind of regretting introducing that championship.
I will say
none of them can help friggin' hold it.
They keep adding people. At this point, I wouldn't be surprised if Jackson has an EBW shirt at some point. But I don't think even they want him.
Yeah, I wouldn't blame them.
Oh, pulling the hair of Jesse Justice here.
Oh!
Did you hear that? Did you hear that?
I feel like it took everything Jesse had there not to just fall onto the floor.
And knock the air out of him, and Jesse, oof. He's back in the ring, barely.
Yeah.
But he's back.
He had enough strength to climb over the middle rope, but that was about it.
Yes, sir. Jackson grabbing the hair.
And now look at this.
What's he doing here for Jesse? Oh!
Side rush and leg sweep.
Taking him for a ride here. And
Jesse trying to roll away. But Jesse, that's veteran ring awareness by Jesse Justice.
He's holding on to that thing for dear life.
Jesse's been around for a while. He knows the ins and outs. Jackson Law is putting his hands on the ref, and that's not a good idea.
No, not at all. Jesse looks like he's sizing him up here. Oh, the roll up!
Roll up!
Oh!
And Jackson rolled clear through. Dead ID! There it is!
And this could be it for Jesse Justice. Oh, no!
It is over.
I thought he had him with the roll up.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match by way of pinfall, and still EBW champion, Jackson Law!
Man, that's just how it goes. The crowd not happy, but a wise man once said, you can't argue with results.
A wise man also once said, ain't that a kick in the head? It pretty much was literally for Justice.
For need of the
head. Elite! Of the elite EBW champion, Law of the Land.
Wow. We apologize for our viewers for having to look at that. But anyway, Jackson Wall is still EBW champion.
And oh man, for a long time, he might hold on to that one. We'll see if he can hold on to it as long as Brogan did. But hey, today he stands tall.
That is very true, ladies and gentlemen. We've got more glory headed your way. Don't go anywhere.
Pushed
him down
the
ground and
I
put him out of the ring. Yeah, I know. That was good.
The
deal
was me and
Robin to
get a little
dead
press, but
really.
I debated on it.
Kind of loose ass
press.
Hey!
The crowd is dead.
The whole contest is scheduled for one fall. So far on is that Corey Lee should be ejected from ringside, but honestly, nobody should be ringside for this. Aaron shouldn't even be reffing it. Nobody should be. Like I said, the only person involved that's not an asshole is Hunter Halkin.
Yeah, that's just how it goes.
Speaking of, look at this asshole.
Wait a minute.
Do you want? Chris Jones joining us on commentary.
Chris Jones?
What the hell are you doing?
I come to join you guys in announcing this great match right here.
I don't need your help, thanks.
How are you guys doing today?
I'd be a lot better if I didn't have to talk to you.
Pretty good,
cover.
I guess.
Two,
look at those covers, those beautiful counts there.
Two count again as Hunter gets his shoulder up. And this time a bridge by Hunter Halkin.
We don't need no outside interference today, so hopefully the referee's watching Corey Lee.
Yeah, no, you got all the outside interference you need with Corey ringside. Corey's gonna do the most damage to Hunter.
Don't you interfere all the time, Chris Jones? I mean, not recently, I will say.
This whole match stinks. There's nothing I like about this match.
It is.
Hunter's the only good part of this match. Everybody else sucks. I'm done being biased.
You are correct. I'm not interfering quite
unbiased.
Well, JJ. Please don't today. Don't just run into the ring.
Don't run into the ring unless it's to face me.
Ouch. Tommy delivering some big time chops. Oh.
Tommy doing what Tommy always does. Oh, but a big shoulder block right to the ring post. That couldn't have felt good.
Hunter is learning things, obviously. Oh!
I just want to point out that Tommy Merriman was accompanied to the ring by the man he tried to murder 2 years ago.
Hey, that's okay. That's okay. That's how it goes. We let bygones be bygones.
Looks like. Hunter Hawkins with a big suicide outside of the ring, and my God, it's a damn shame he didn't succeed in taking Tommy Merriman's head off.
Times have changed, Blackheart. The enemy of my enemy is my friend, I believe they say.
Yeah. Interesting that you waited for me to retire to come back.
Yeah. It was the perfect opportunity for EBW to try to come back and take over. You know, that's not the only reason I'm here. Uh-huh. I did say there was four targets. Maybe that's why I'm out here.
Uh-huh.
Uh-oh. I mean, we see two. Yeah, Chris Jones saying he's going to go after his four targets and then retire.
I got news for you. I'm not a target. I'm more of a Best Buy.
Well, hey, he has got two left. We'll just have to see who they are before the career of Chris Jones comes to a close.
Trying for that ripcord into the cyclone, but no. Ripcord into the cyclone. No, wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Not what Chris Jones wanted to see.
And that's the most excited I've ever seen Corey Lee about Hunter Halkin.
And that's covered. How you do it.
But of course, Aaron Schaffner is the referee, so I can't expect him to call it down the middle.
Yeah, I mean, you know, he's got that EBW shirt.
His ref shirt doesn't even have an XCW patch on anymore.
I was literally about to say that. There's no XCW.
He ripped the patch off of it. What a dick.
Huh. Big surprise there.
Why do you think I'm not being professional about that? I don't care. I hope Hunter Hawkins destroys all of them.
Including
his own partner.
Hunter Halkin's not a guy to be messed with. He's not a rookie anymore. Hunter Halkin is a superstar.
Yeah, okay. That's the only thing I've ever agreed with you on. Hunter Halkin climbing up to the top for those punches. Two, three, four. Count them along, Galaxy. Seven, eight, nine, and that's a mistake.
Hunter Halkin definitely doesn't need Corey Lee.
Good God! Hunter Halkin might be dead. Hunter Halkin might be dead. Cover by Tommy Merriman, and a kick out by a very valiant Hunter Halkin.
I was very shocked when Hunter finally gave in to Corey Lee. It shocked the hell out of me. Yeah, I didn't expect it.
I'm sure Corey's not happy about him stopping to gloat about the 10 punches, but at the same time, Corey's an ass too, so.
Powerbomb felt personal, Christ almighty.
Big stalling kill switch by Tommy Merriman. Here's the cover. One, two, and again. Hunter Halkin. I've always said Hunter Halkin was a resilient individual. He proved it during his time as international champion. He's proving it here now.
And ref Aaron not doing a terrible job, you know, calling it down the middle, I guess. That's been a couple, you know,
questionable. He needs to go to the table because he can suck it.
Oh, word. Oh.
Yes, that was actually two words, JJ.
Oh, suck it.
Yeah.
Tommy the Man Merriman back.
Let's not infringe on other people's gimmicks.
Back in control here. He's got Hunter Halkin right where he wants him in the corner here. And Hunter, oh, wait a minute.
Hunter trying to fight back.
Let's see if he's going to be able to do it. He looks a little hurt here, holding the ribs. And
oh, Tommy tried to charge at him, and Hunter was ready.
Look at this. Buddy.
Tommy caught him. Hunter trying to fix it. Oh my God, big face buster by Hunter Halkin. This could be
the
kill. One, two, no!
Would Aaron even count the three?
I don't know. He looks like he's got a dirty Sanchez on his face anyway, so whatever.
What a mean person you are, Blackheart.
I am only mean to those who deserve it.
Too close is correct, Chris Jones. Are you,
God.
I was going to ask if you were worried, but probably not so much anymore. Tommy's a resilient superstar, so I'm not too worried. You know, I got some other stuff on my mind about matches later on the evening, so
JJ,
lots of stuff on EBW's plate, JJ.
Let me let you in on a secret, JJ. Chris Jones is never worried anymore because I'm retired.
No word.
Big spear by Tommy Merriman. Here's the cover. One, two, and by Corey Lee.
He's up there trying to hop in the ring, even though...
Throw him out!
Throw him out! Oh, man, come on, Chris.
While you're at it, throw Chris Jones off the commentary table.
Hey, I mean, come on.
We were doing just fine without him, JJ.
But he's been good.
Oh, Hunter Hopkins knocked into his... Oh, my God, big insecurity by Hunter Hopkins, and Corey Lee's on the floor
where he
belongs, by the way.
He wasn't happy about that one. I don't know if Corey Lee's going to be happy about getting hit. It wasn't even Hunter's fault, though.
Cover by Hunter. One, two. Two count only. No, it was not Hunter's fault, but who do you think is going to take the punishment for it?
Hunter, unfortunately.
Why do you think I hate this so much, JJ?
It's just, you know, Hunter's...
This is not good for Hunter. Remember who brought him into this? It was me.
He's not the same.
I was his first match as his tag partner.
He's not the same likable guy, you know. He was back in the day.
He is to me, goddammit.
Oh, whatever.
It's still real to me.
Whatever. I think the more he's with Corey Lee, the less stock he has, to be honest. Oh, big words from...
Oh, my God!
Nike Superman punch out of the air there. Oh, my God.
How in the world is Hunter Hopkins going to come back from this?
Hunter seeing stars here. That may be it for him. I'd rather see Hunter return to his former glory, to be honest. Hey, he was doing better before he was with Corey Lee. I mean, I know he wasn't doing well in the end there, but definitely...
Cyclone I've ever seen by Tommy Merriman.
It's about to say it's a little longer than usual, and there it is!
At the 30.
EBW wins! Always a pleasure, fellas. Thanks for being up here, Chris.
The pleasure's all yours.
Thanks for not super kicking me or Blackheart. Much appreciated.
I would have just done it right back. The winner of this match as a result of a pinfall, Tommy the Man Merriman! Corey Lee's probably gonna beat the hell out of Hunter Hopkins. This is just abuse.
Corey's
pointing
to Chris Jones. He says,
look, he's gonna beat the hell out of Hunter. Look at this.
Why is he gonna try everybody, though, is the real question.
Look at him. See, he's blaming Hunter like it wasn't 3-on-1 in that match.
I mean, The ref called it pretty fair. It could have been worse. That close third pin, that three count could have been a pin. Hey, see, he let...
I cannot possibly feel worse for Hunter Hopkins.
He let him off with the
three. I can't possibly feel worse for Hunter Hopkins. It's a 3-on-1 match, basically 4-on-1 with Corey out there. You've got to feel bad for Hunter Hopkins. I cannot believe what he's being put through. Ladies and gentlemen, we got more glory on the way, including tag team title action. Stick around. We'll be right back.
You see, as I'm laying here in the decimation from my match against Shane Shaw, I put an end to Shane. Today at Glory, I ended Shane Shaw's career. Put an end. And well, I love anything, and I mean anything, that causes chaos. I live and breathe evil. Everything about me is pure from the heart. And well, you know, I will say, I love the color black, but it's got me to thinking. I'm looking at something more, and that single's gold.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is a tornado tag match for the XCW Tag Team Championship. Introducing first, being accompanied by Chris Jones. At a combined weight of 460 pounds, the team of
would buy LOL a six pack of Corona if he can come back, please.
No.
So we don't have to see Chris Jones
maybe
anymore.
XCW will.
Have you ever seen them two in a ring at the same time? I haven't.
No.
And their opponents. At a combined weight of 320 pounds, they are the XCW Tag Team Champions of the World, Justin Parsley, Rob Slater, the Real Wolves.
Hot damn, they are here and they are ready to party, ladies and gentlemen.
I will buy LOL a bottle of hot damn.
No.
You just reminded me.
The last time that happened, no.
I don't care. I'd rather that.
We almost lost the news last time that happened.
I bet LOL would hit.
Yeah, sure. What would Justin? She had to ask him.
He kicks some ass and takes some names. I think he's about to do that here. He did it to the foundation.
Jesus Parsley, Justin Parsley.
Foundation, who was supposed to be here tonight in this match as a triple threat match. Unfortunately, they are injured. Nice, yes. Very much so. They are injured, unfortunately, not able to make it here tonight. So this became a 2-on-2 tornado tag match. Right. EBW guys are making out.
Now they're praying, I think. I don't know.
They better. They should. Because we know which team has Jesus on their side in this match, and it ain't EBW.
We don't need no goddamn Jesus.
I don't think he realizes the irony of saying goddamn Jesus.
I think he's got this is a family show. Don't say that. Don't say that.
Yeah, work at a CVS and tell me there's a God. Tag title's on the line here. Tornado rules. It means all four men are legal at the same time. One fall to a finish.
Ooh.
Yeah, Chris Jones is not a part of this match. He needs to leave the ring.
Yeah, he's going. He's out. Steve got his work cut out for him. I feel like this is going to be a chaotic match.
Cerebral in there by himself against both members of the real ones. Oh my God! Real to real! Already! Cover!
Christ!
Chris Jones pulling Steve-O out of the ring, out of his shoe.
There was no interference last match, but there's definitely some here.
I think Chris Jones sprained his vagina pulling Steve-O out of the ring.
Whoa!
Hey, I can say it. Okay. I can take it. You can.
Okay.
Brandy Branson gets Justin Parsley by the hair. Good Lord, just beating on him in the corner there.
Christ almighty. The real ones take out Brandy Branson early, but he's back in a big way. And oh!
Slater sent to the corner by James Cerebral. Brandy Branson, head of steam, hits that ring post with his head because he's so damn tall. The only person taller than him in this match is Rob Slater, I'll tell you that.
I can't even count how tall he is now.
I thought Cerebral was going to hit his own tag partner. That would have been a comedy of errors.
Hey, you never know. You never know. It's a chaotic match here, these tornado tag team matches. This EBW just...
It's a chaotic life, JJ.
They're beating up the champions right now. It's not looking good here.
It isn't. It really isn't. Big chop to Rob Slater.
Oh, man. Oh!
Good Lord.
Did you hear that? Oh!
It's like bubble wrap. Fisherman suplex by Justin Parsley into the pin and two count.
Close, but no cigar. They're trying to get a win early.
Boy, would a Brady Branson look stupid there if he didn't do something.
Yep.
And he looks stupid anyway. He would look stupider.
No! Brady Branson, a great wrestler before he joined EBW. You know, now he's not so good because he joined EBW.
Uh-huh. He had to cheat his way to the XCW Championship.
The old Brady Branson. Never.
You want the tag titles? Come on, get them!
Jesus! As he gets a kick to the face for his troubles there, JP.
JP didn't hit Cerebral hard enough, in my opinion.
Oh, it's Brady going after the leg of Slater over here, and oh, man. Oh, and he just had an insult to injury. Oh!
Crushing the back of his thigh and then driving his knee into the ground, and now Justin Parsley and Brady Branson going to go at it here. Oh! Neck breaker right on the back of Russell. people there to break it up immediately.
Going for the count, and oh man, this is about as chaotic as I thought it would be. EBW, they were in control, and now the real ones, and now it's really anybody's game again. Oh!
Everybody except Brady on their feet here. Brady rolling out of the ring to get himself a second, leaving Cerebral by himself in the ring. Big double suplex by the real ones, and now Brady pulling Rob Slater out of the ring. Landing face first on the gym floor, Cerebral in a predicament there, but JP not able to put him away.
Making it look easy here is Brady. Oh!
With a pan to the back.
Side to front.
Oh, God. That's completely legal in this match, by the way. You don't have to. Oh, my God.
Justin Parsley. Oh, the best laid plans. Thought he was going to go up and get a big hit on James Cerebral.
I shouldn't have to say it, but like the tag, tornado tag is no DQ. We saw it at encounters when they faced, when the real ones faced the foundation, and we're seeing it here.
100%. Unfortunately, the foundation isn't able to be here, but hey!
The brands of oh!
I'm sure that's not the last we've seen of them, is everybody down except James Cerebral.
Yeah, I'm sure landing on that pan didn't feel good for Brady either. Not that I care.
Not at all. Cover! Okay, go!
Parsley able to kick out.
Parsley almost losing the match there, but thankfully a kick out.
Oh, and shoulder right into the ring post. Rob Slater in trouble on the outside.
Let's say we saw EBW, Tommy the Man Merriman beating Hunter Halkin here. Oh!
Big DDT by Parsley.
And now, hopefully, Chris Jones might see another one. Hopefully not, but trying to bring home some gold here for EBW.
Oh my goodness.
I wonder if he liked that.
Probably not, I would imagine.
Trying to taunt the crowd here.
I don't know very many people who enjoy getting punched in the back of the head.
I do, strangely enough.
Yeah, but that's because you paid the hooker for that.
It is a little extra.
Cerebral into the brick wall there. This complete chaos now.
We
kind of expected because
I told you.
Just remember their match with the Foundation.
Oh!
A few weeks ago at Encounters. This is turning out about the same way at this point.
They're just stacking bodies here on the wall. Rob Slater barely able to walk here as he's just tossed into. Oh, wait!
And Brady gets tossed into the wall.
Everybody down is.
I love how Chris Jones pounded on the apron despite nobody being in the ring.
Chris Jones looks on.
It's all he can do. It's all he should be doing is looking on.
Trying to hit using a crutch.
I wouldn't get involved in this anyway, even if it was to help my team. This is dangerous.
Using a crutch from one of the audience members, EBW really doesn't care.
EBW's never cared about hurting audience members. They don't care about these audience members. This is the XCW Galaxy, not the EBW Galaxy.
We do remember, yes, that kid. Chris Jones tossing him out like a sack of potatoes. But I'm sure Luke Blaze could pay for this lady's medical bills if it gets too crazy. Uh-oh.
Yeah, you know, Luke Blaze isn't here today. He's probably in the Bahamas.
Yep. Oh!
Getting his taint licked.
It still isn't spring yet. I don't blame him here.
It's not spring here. No, it sucks here, but it's spring in the Bahamas.
EBW getting waylaid here. Brady Branson standing tall here.
Rob Slater made it back into the ring somehow. He's got one bad wheel, and he's asking Brady to bring it on, which any other day is a smart idea because it's Brady. But on this occasion, I don't know if it's such a smart idea.
I think he just can't walk very well, and he's like, please, God, get in here. Look, size to each other up here on the side.
Dropkick takes down Rob Slater.
Justin Parsley and James Cerebral here.
Threw Cerebral into that padded wall, and there's not much padding on that wall. And now Parsley back into the ring to help out his tag partner. Thank God for that. That's half of the sweet chin security.
Not good here for
that was the insecurity
EBW.
Partner. Cerebral a mile away from the ring right now. Two and no. Rob Slater just about had him there. And Cerebral getting his getting his ass handed to him again. Oh, no!
God!
Parsley was sent headfirst into the boards here at ringside.
I think it gave him a concussion.
They're still a mile away from the ring. Brady's in the ring, wrapping that pin around Rob Slater's ankle. It's not going to feel good for him. He's trying to cut him down to size.
No, he's making him a cast.
Big body slam on the floor by Cerebral to Parsley. And Brady Branson just trying to wreck Rob Slater, trying to take a couple feet off of his height.
Steve-O trying to kick it away here and not...
I mean, there's nothing... That's all he can do is try to get that weapon as far away from everybody as possible. Speaking of weapons, Cerebral just smacked Parsley in the head with that water bottle.
No,
I don't
everywhere.
Know who he got that water bottle from. Who the hell gave him a water bottle?
It's everywhere.
No, it's Evian.
Oh, it's Evian. Sorry.
Yeah. Smacked in the head with that folded up pan. That ain't gonna be good for baking nothing now.
EBW in firm control right now. The tag champions in a world of hurt. This may be the end of the reign.
Parsley just ran into Chris Jones. He didn't hit him hard enough.
There's a lot of bad blood between Chris Jones and Parsley.
Too bad he didn't get ran into the ring.
Brady, oh, look at that!
Oh, scary takeover by Parsley. Cover up Brady Branson. 1-2. No, Cerebral started paying attention to me.
Look at Steve-O with the action shot there. That was beautiful.
Parsley with a sliver of hope there to try to retain the tag team titles, but not on this occasion, as Cerebral now the only man standing in the ring.
Uh-oh. EBW.
He's got that gold chain off from around his neck, and he's got it around his
waist.
Blocked JP with it. Completely legal.
Not looking good for the tag champs over here.
And now he's going to do the same thing to the 97 feet tall Rob Slater.
Uh-oh.
Cerebral caught his own tag partner. Cerebral hit Brady.
That's not good. Oh, wait a minute.
Out of nowhere.
RKO, and this could be it. The tag champions. This could be the opportunity they were hoping for.
Down. Who's going to be the first to their feet here?
Are they going to be able to capitalize?
Is Rob Slater even going to be able to get to his feet? Has his ankle worked for the last 10 minutes? Chris Jones trying to tell this crowd to shut up. They're not going to listen to him. He turned their backs on them, not the other way around.
Uh-oh.
Oh! Oh! Check by JP, almost into the ropes.
Uh-oh.
Big flapjack pile driver.
I can't even
Branson, tell. Just Cerebral's out of the ring. Oh, my God. Oh, and Parsley brought Brady down. Into that inverted bulldog and nearly took him out there. My God. Brady Branson tried to razor's edge, and Parsley was able to reverse it and reverse bulldog him down to the ground. And now Parsley going up top.
This just keeps going back and forth and back and forth and back and forth.
It's insane. Big frog splash by Justin Parsley. Cover. 2. No. Cerebral pulls Parsley out of the ring.
Tag champions.
Or not out of the ring, but off of the cover at least.
Oh, close but no cigar here.
Good Lord, what is it going to take?
Brady barely kicking out as Chris Jones not happy here, trying to get EBW on the same page. And they have been rather unsuccessful in the tag division lately. Oh!
Good God.
James Cerebral smacking with a trash can?
With a pizza pan to the
face. Pizza pan.
What is Brady? Look at Brady. He's untying the turnbuckle.
Rob Slater unable to walk here as Brady. Oh!
And the turnbuckle pad off in plain view of the ref. Not that there's anything that Steve-O can do about it.
The crowd, not a fan of EBW, obviously.
EBW stands for Everyone's Baking Waffles.
Oh, hell yeah.
I could get behind that.
Everyone bakes waffles.
Not me. I burn eggs, baby. Bigfoot DDT there to Rob Slater.
EBW.
Here comes JP.
Oh.
Cerebral able to cut him off in the pass, and EBW looks to be firmly in control here. Tornado tag match, titles on the line here at Glory in the 21st anniversary show. Big DDT to JP by JC.
Christ almighty. Oh.
Break his leg.
And now JP's head gonna go right into that exposed turnbuckle.
Wants to break his leg. Oh, ah! Right on
good
that
Lord.
Knee. Oh man.
Doesn't matter how tall you are if you're laying down on the mat. And now Brady Branson on the second rope. Oh my God, big elbow drop to the knee.
Oh man.
I don't know how Rob's ever gonna walk now.
I don't think he can. He was barely walking before. Now this?
This might be a handicap match in the most literal sense now. Where's JP's in the corner and he's up against both.
We're just gonna have to
Cerebral and Branson. JP's in the corner, down.
EBW, standing tall here.
Standing tall. Rob finally back to his one good foot. I don't even know how he's back to that one, I'll be honest.
Look at Chris Jones.
Look at Chris Jones. He's got a hold of JP in the corner. Steve-O sees it. He can't do nothing about it because it's a tornado tag match. This is absolute horse shit.
Oh, really working on that leg. He's about to... Oh!
Good Lord. Yeah! Sidewalk slam by Brady Branson.
And now Justin Parsley in the corner.
Parsley is being restrained by Cerebral and Chris Jones. And Parsley trying his best to fight out of it, but it's not working.
He's just holding. He's all. Every time he almost gets out, I just feel like there's nothing Parsley can do. He's just. Oh!
Oh, balls first into the ring post. Of course, the only way that EPW could win a championship is by cheating.
Just has to watch his partner. Oh my God.
And now Cerebral gonna wrap that leg around the ring post in figure four.
Oh,
oh
buddy.
Oh, for God's sake.
He tapped! Oh, buddy, he tapped, it's over.
The winners of this match, as a result of a submission, and new XCW Tag Team Champions, James Cerebral and Brady Branson.
Come on.
Yeah, but look what they had to do to make it happen. Chris Jones had to get involved. Brady Branson couldn't take a shit without Chris Jones being there.
I don't know if Rob Slater's ever
going to
walk again.
Look at those worthless stacks of crap holding our tag championship.
It's been a good day for EBW. This may be their year. I hate to say
I've been a two-time tag champ, and I am ashamed to share a lineage with those two hats. And that has been Chris Jones.
Oh, buddy, the time keeps coming. And we have new tag team champions, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't wait for EBW to die like it did 12 years ago. I'm sick of them, JJ.
Look what they had to do to take the tag titles away from JP
and Rob. Look what they had to do. They had to get Chris Jones involved. Fuck Chris Jones and fuck EBW.
I'm rubbing it in the faces now. You love to see it. No, you don't. You hate it.
Chris Jones just better be glad I'm retired.
Let's go.
Can't stop me, can't stop me. 그래도 늘 다 뒤지 마.
Get ready, get ready, dreamin' area. Get ready, dreamin' area.
Can't stop me, can't stop me. 나를 이긴
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the XCW International Champion, Eric Mason.
This that Southern playalistic, Willie smoking whiskey, sipping Southern like my mama's kitchen, gravy biscuits, fried chicken,
I take over the world in that Canadian lumberjack match against Leon Lovegood. By the way, not here tonight. He must be looking for me.
I think he might be in the hospital. I don't know, dude.
He's got a mic in his pants, and he's also happy to see him.
Hell yeah!
Let's hear from the chain.
No.
XCW Galaxy, how we doing tonight, baby? Yeah. Woo!
Oh, wait. I mean, I'm doing
as good. You can tell, it's like
sorry.
Pretty purple belt here, you know. I did what I said I was going to do when I beat down Leon Lux, and if you ask me, I think it's time to move on. And if you know from last season in my New Age run, I'm a fighting champion. So I'm out here for my first ever International Champion Open Challenge. Whoever wants the old school ass whooping, you know where to find me.
In the vein of Hunter Halkin and his run as International Champion, Eric Mason doing what his best friend would do and putting the belt on the line, but against who? Oh boy. The following is a International Championship match, scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, the challenger, weighing in at 165 pounds, from Boise, Idaho, Corey Lees.
Oh, buddy, after Hunter Halkin not able to get it done today, is he going to be able to win and become International Champion?
Is Hunter's best friend. And now his new master, I guess, is facing him for the International Championship. Has somebody ever won all the titles in the span of a year? Because if he wins this, if Corey wins this, this would be his third title in the last 365 calendar days that he's won. And it'd be the second time he's won one off of Eric Mason.
Alright, let's hope he just doesn't win tonight.
These two do have a history. They had that Cradle to the Grave match back and Hit the Light, where they absolutely beat the tar out of each other. Circumstances are a little different now. It's a different belt.
Oh yeah, it's that shiny purple new belt.
And you gotta think Hunter might be rooting for his friend here, but of course he doesn't want to draw the ire of Corey Lee.
That was a good word.
All right.
You used the word I, that was good.
Here we go. And here we are underway for the international title.
Like I said, you gotta believe Hunter Halkin is watching this, possibly sitting next to a man with an orange hat.
Crowd, not a fan though, not a fan of Corey Lee.
Like, okay. Like Corey Lee cares. Have you seen his attitude? He's the one. He's basically FXCW and FEBW. I only have to agree with him. I agree on the FEBW part, but.
But he writes about it in his diary. Oh!
I don't think there's been very few people that have been more XCW than I am, and I can tell you, absolutely not FXCW.
Oh, buddy. These two sizing each other up.
Yeah, well, Eric Mason has the size advantage. He's got about 150 pounds on Corey Lee as it is.
Oh, yeah, 100%. He's just tossing Corey Lee around like a ragdoll already.
And you would think Corey has the speed advantage, but actually it's kind of even in that department. Eric Mason is one of the fastest big men you'll ever see.
Quite agile.
Wait till he tries to run a train on Corey and you'll see it. Throw some deer piss on him and hunt him like Buck.
Okay,
gotta get him in the ring somehow.
All right. I mean, is that legal? Can you do that?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't know about the hunting part, but you can absolutely throw deer urine on someone.
Huh.
It's not really
interesting.
Illegal.
Interesting.
Round upon.
I'm gonna save that for later.
Big chop in the corner by Eric Mason. Here he comes, and wow. Mason misses and collides at the ring post head first.
Corey Lee wisely dodging that. That could have been bad. Like you said, 150 pound advantage.
Yeah. But also remember that Corey Lee has beaten Eric Mason before. These two faced off for the New Age title late last year. Corey Lee won the title from Mason, lost it back to him in the Cradle for the Grave match at Hit the Lights. So, I mean, Corey is no stranger to Eric Mason and probably knows the keys to victory here.
You gotta think if he can beat him in a Cradle to the Grave match, he can beat him here. The crowd firmly behind Eric Mason here as he's trying to fight Corey Lee back, trying to fight to his feet here.
How do you know they're cheering for Eric Mason? My name's Eric too.
Oh, I mean, that's true. It's probably for you, you're right.
No, it's not, it's for Eric Mason. You gotta wonder who Hunter Halkin is pulling for in this match.
I don't know.
You would think Eric Mason, his best friend.
He's probably torn right now.
A year ago, these two were sitting on a couch playing video games together, and now this. Oh my God! I don't mean Corey Lee.
I told you, if you don't dodge it, it's bad news, and uh-oh.
Come on, man!
That's Corey Lee seems more like a Call of Duty fan to me, you know, stale games with no inspiration.
Classier gamer, actually.
I'll probably
be
get
surprised.
Blamed for that. That's all right. I don't care. I'm tough. Bring it on. Corey Lee back to his feet. So is Eric Mason. Right hands. What is this? Is he going to seriously try to Alabama slam a guy from Alabama? That's not going to fucking work.
Uh-oh.
Goodbye, Corey Lee. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Look out. Jesus Christ.
Christ almighty.
Oh, my God. Somebody check on these two.
Both of them.
That was a nasty landing for Corey Lee and for Eric Mason. I'm looking over the table and I think Corey might actually legitimately be hurt. I think Eric might legitimately be hurt.
Both men tumbling out of the ring. Fest
Jesus.
Checking on them both.
That's a lot of weight to land on Corey Lee. I mean, I don't like Corey Lee, but he is a human being after all. Jesus.
Right,
Mason trying to get back to his feet here.
I think we're good here.
I hope so. You still never know the long-term effects of something like that. That was horrendous, that fall. Here it is again, my God. Just taking him, trying to Alabama slam Eric Mason is a futile attempt in itself, but this head scissors over the top, nasty.
Tosses him, oh
good
man.
God.
Hurry up and go home, dude.
One!
I think Corey's still feeling the effects. He's over here trying to shake it off.
Two.
Got to get it together here. Both of these men hurting.
Three.
Corey's in a daze.
But you got to get it back in the ring here.
Four.
Mason's back is hurting him. I think Corey's finally shaking it off enough to continue. Like I said, I don't like Corey Lee, but he is a human being, and I would never want anybody to get seriously hurt.
Oh, good.
Except for EBW.
Well, don't worry, no EBW competitors.
But I don't view them as human beings.
Hey, maybe next match, who knows? I hope not.
Corey Lee finally managing to get Eric Mason back in the ring. He's looking, he's feeling the long-term effects of that already.
I
it's not looking good.
I don't blame him.
It's hard to like Corey Lee, but I am concerned. I am legitimately concerned about him right now.
He's not quitting though. I'll give him that. He's not giving up.
I mean, he and I have a history together too.
Ooh, a romantic history?
No.
Oh.
No, jackass.
Oh shit. Okay.
An in-ring history.
Oh, I I just had to clarify.
Where's your head tonight, JJ?
I just had to clarify for the
oh my God, look at this!
Viewers at home!
Mason!
Oh, buddy!
Big snake eyes in the corner! Oh my God! Just runs over Corey Lee!
Corey Lee, uh-oh. He is in a world of... Oh, Hunter Hauken, what's... Uh-oh.
What is Hunter here?
I guess we'll see what side he's really on. Is he helping his...
What is...
Uh-oh, he is helping Corey Lee, I think.
Hunter helping Corey Lee? I didn't expect that.
I told you, this is a different Hunter Hauken. I told you, not the same one you thought you knew.
Boom!
Uh-oh, he's going to take them both out.
Oh, look out, look out, look out.
Oh, no! Oh!
And Eric Mason just ran over his friend.
No! No!
Corey Lee was able to get out of the way, and Mason hit his own friend with the Mason Express.
You hate to see it.
Mason in disbelief.
Uh-oh, hopefully this doesn't disrupt his headspace here.
I think the only reason Hunter's coming out here to check on Corey is so that Corey don't beat him up later.
I mean, hey, that's a sound strategy.
Corey is pissed. Look at this. Big knees. I think whatever ill effects that head scissors over the top did, I think he's shaking them off right now and is working through his adrenaline.
Corey Lee just unhinged right now.
I mean, he's always been unhinged, but he's even more so at this moment.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Getting dumped on his head must have lit a fire under him. Big double knees right to the midsection.
Uh-oh.
Gonna do it again? Oh, that running knee, but he blocked it.
Just tackled him, knocked him to the canvas there.
Mason like a big sequoia tree. It's hard to take him down. Corey almost did it there.
But you know, Mason had to feel some of that as well. Running into those knees of Corey Lee as he just, oh! Maybe not, maybe he didn't.
Big tree limb-like arms just smacking up against Corey's midsection here.
Maybe
Mason getting upset now.
Maybe Eric is a tree.
It's very possible.
I think he might be.
He is Groot.
A tree person. Groot. Uh-oh, Hunter Hauken back in here.
What is Hunter doing?
I don't think you can do that.
Hunter is trying to un... Oh, I found out! Corey Lee! Hunter's still got the referee distracted! But, look at this! Yeah. Hunter's still got the referee distracted!
This is gonna be a couple lashes for Hunter Hauken here. That's
Corey
sure.
Lee had the pinfall on Eric Mason, and Hunter had him distracted. Oh, that's not good. He turned his back, and that was a mistake. Southpaw! Eric Mason nails it! Cover! It's over! The winner of this match, as a result of a pinfall, and still XCW International Champion, Eric Mason!
There he is, able to pull off a win, thanks to Hunter Hauken, or, you know, maybe not so thanks. That was an accident, of course, but,
ow.
Yeah, that's what I thought would happen. Corey Lee let him off easy once.
Just trying to help.
Trying to help?
Yes.
Yeah?
That's what you wanted, isn't it?
Trying to help.
Yeah, see?
You
told you.
Fucking
you questioned me, JJ, and I seem to know how it goes. And look at this.
I told you he was trying to help. Uh-oh, this is not going to be good.
Calm down.
Uh-oh.
You lost. Okay, get over it.
Put him in between. He just destroyed Hunter Hauken.
Holy shit!
I guess Hunter made his choice. Maybe it's a.
Are you sure Hunter made a choice?
But maybe it's.
Are
a
you
new...
sure Mason didn't make a choice? Look at this! Southpaw on Hunter Hauken.
Hey, Eric Mason gave him plenty of chances to move, to get out of the way, and look what happened.
Look at this!
Look what happened.
Mason and Corey Lee almost killed each other over the International Championship. Triumphant by Corey Lee, my God. These two just about killed each other over the International Championship, and now they're beating down Hunter Hauken.
What did Chris Jones say to any of you in my enemy?
What the hell is this?
I can't say that word.
What the hell is this? This is bullshit.
A part of the plan all along.
Are you kidding me?
I don't understand. I don't understand. Why would Aaron Mason do this after everything he's been through?
JJ, I never want you to doubt me again.
Like, you saw this coming. Get out of here.
I didn't see that, but I called that he made a choice. His choice was to hell with honor.
Yeah, but I'm not going to give you that. Yeah, he made a choice. Oh, my, what the?
Well, but it wasn't Hunter Hopkins' fault, is what I'm trying to say.
I guess. Corey Lee has a new disciple.
Yeah, and anybody who thought that Hunter Hopkins had turned over a leaf, I think you're mistaken.
I don't even know what to say.
My God, I don't know if I have the words to recount what I just witnessed. Corey Lee, even though he didn't even win the match, is walking away with the International Championship in his grasp, on his shoulder, and he has left Hunter Hopkins laying in the ring. This is absolutely unbelievable, JJ. We've got more glory on the way. Stay tuned. Our main event is coming up next. ACT, Miano Diaz, Legacy Rules. Stick around.
The following contest is a Legacy Rules match for the XCW Championship.
EBW.
Introducing first, being accompanied by Chris Jones from Albuquerque, New Mexico, weighing in at 125 pounds, soaking wet. This is Miano.
You know, I hope the person that owns this building makes him mop the floors for doing that. You know, they say you can take a wrong turn at Albuquerque. I think Albuquerque took a wrong turn to be on a deal.
I see what you did there. Cut out for him here.
And his opponent,
weighing at 900 pounds,
being accompanied to the ring by SAT Scott Anthony Thompson from Harvard University, weighing in at 225 pounds, he is the reigning and defending XCW champion of the world. Yep, we still got Judas as the ref, but at least the sides are a little more evened up. We saw ACT in action against Julie Boyd Jacobs earlier in the pre-show, successfully winning that match. Let's hope his brother can do the same here. Legacy rules. What are the rules of the legacy rules, JJ?
It's going to be 4 3-minute rounds. Each competitor is going to go until the time is up or until a pinfall is made. And at the end of 4 rounds, we see who wins. Hopefully, best 2 out of 3 falls. Whoever comes out with the most wins. Let's hope not for a tie or anything like that. That would be fun. Everybody likes a win.
Unless it's for EBW.
Okay, nobody would like that. Nobody wants that. Okay.
Keep telling you this.
Right. Bangers can be choosers. But hey, the first round, like I said, we'll start when the ref rings the bell. It's 3 minutes. And then between each round, you have a 20-second rest period. So ring the bell and we are underway, ladies and gentlemen.
The first 10-minute period of how many did you say? Four? Three? Four?
It is 4 3-minute periods.
4 3-minute periods. So the first 3-minute period of the match. And already, look at this, Alex Cardona Thompson trying to go for the pinfall early. Miano just kicked him right in the face. Yeah, of course Chris loved that. Chris probably taught him how to do it.
You're right.
ACT trying to win early, and unfortunately, not going to happen. Oh, man.
Miano might not be a big human being, but that's still a lot of weight on his shoulder. I would be remiss if I didn't mention again that Judas was the referee.
I think his name's Aaron.
Not anymore.
Oh, okay.
I have a couple other names for him, too, but I'm not going to say them on camera.
Ref Judas. Yeah, this is a family show, remember?
Say despite it. The fact that I said the F word like 2 matches ago. Well,
hey, I told you this. So. I said this is a family show. I tried to stop you.
Hey, how are families made? The F word.
Oh, buddy. Anyway, it's been 1 minute. 1 minute in this contest.
Cover. Nope. ACT able to escape that.
That's just how it is. Look, he's just not giving it to Miano, thankfully.
Hey, I heard that.
I don't even think it. Okay. I was
right there. Wow. You know, officials aren't supposed to talk that way to the wrestlers. Somebody should fine him.
Miano probably shouldn't have done that. Somebody should fine anybody.
Look out. Big right hand right across the face of Miano. Hope he breaks his jaw. Oh, there's the face wash.
Yes, sir.
That's for the fan that loves the face wash. And I know that because I saw him comment on the last video.
Yes, sir, and here we are approaching that 2-minute mark.
Oh my God.
And there we are, 2 minutes left, 1 minute, or 2 minutes have elapsed, 1 minute left in the first round.
Are you sure you know the rules of this match?
I think so, I just can't, numbers hard, math hard.
Math is hard, I will give you that. I'm hard with the calculus right now. This is a XCW championship match here at Glory. Our main event tonight. I'm glad you could be here for us. We will be back again in 2 weeks
for Hungry for Gold. We already know one match happening that show. Triple threat for the New Age Championship as Evan Phoenix will defend against JLS.
30 seconds left.
That's fine. When it comes to the rules of the match, talk over me. I do not mind.
30 seconds, 20 seconds left now. And this
ACT
first
tried
round.
For the skull crushing finale, but Miano was able to cut it into a deadly dog.
And there's only 10 seconds, he better get a pin.
Cover one, two, and three.
There it is! The first round goes to Miano Diaz, just in the nick of time. And now they get a 20-second
rest period now. And if you think that Aaron Schopper's going to enforce that, you're wrong. I don't expect him to enforce the rules fairly in this match, do you?
Nope, I mean, we still have like 10 seconds left, but okay. There we go, Steely, everybody getting a thing of water here, you know.
Chris Jones trying desperately to get me on a DS.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All righty, that bell means we are back in the second round here.
All right, honkies, time in.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The first round going to Miano Diaz over here.
Side headlock by ACT.
ACT got to tie it up here. If Miano wins, the match is over, and he becomes XCW champion.
That's right. I mean, I'm assuming that's right. I still don't understand the rules. But you know the rules better than I do, so that's all that matters.
I don't understand numbers, but I do understand the rules.
Yes. How about I deal with the numbers, you deal with the rules.
That works for me.
Strengths. ACT working to his strength right now, putting Miano in the corner. Look at this. They're trying to break his arm.
Oh, look at that fast count there by the...
Yeah, fast count by Judas.
He did so good the first match.
His upper lip is dirty. Somebody should tell him to wash it.
If my poor monkey smooth brain is correct, I believe 1 minute has elapsed in this match.
Oh,
2 minutes left.
I thought you were calling Aaron another name. Can't really say. That's pretty inventive.
No, that monkey's smooth brain mother. Oh, wait. Family show.
Oh,
family
show. Come on. And Aaron applauded that. Because, you know, that's what an impartial referee does, right?
I mean,
he applauds Miano Diaz's efforts.
I'm sure it was
and
a
fast counts at ACT. That's exactly what he does.
It was a good maneuver, obviously. I mean,
what are you talking about? That's how it works in wrestling. Don't you know?
They can have opinions.
It's been a minute
and then
and
Chris
a half.
Jones comes out and helps his team win the tag titles. That's how it works.
On to the cold, hard ground.
He says he did nothing. He forgot the word important. He did nothing important.
Oh, come on now, Eric. Come on now.
I'm bitter, okay?
It sounds like it. It's okay, though. We still love you. Ladies
on the outside.
Ladies and gentlemen, two minutes down. We have 1 minute left in the contest here. I'm sorry. 1 minute left in the round.
I thought you knew the rules, JJ.
Hey, I'm getting there. Baby steps. Miano Diaz, one a little
slow. Speaking of baby steps, that's all Miano Diaz can take. Look at this. Oh!
Ouch. Ladies and gentlemen, he's getting up there, ladies and gentlemen.
Tope Suicida through the top and middle ropes, and both men are on the outside. And look at Aaron not starting a count.
Hey, I mean, it's...
We should be up to four by now. Come on. This is ridiculous.
Yes,
can we have a better referee? Or
it's been
a
some
referee?
Seconds.
A referee would be nice.
30 seconds left. 30 seconds left in the round. Hopefully this goes to a draw or ACT pins him, because if Miano does, it's over.
Yeah, ACT only needs to lose one more time to lose the title. But look at this! Fujiwara armbar by ACT! Rip that arm out of its socket, beat him with it!
10 seconds!
Miano Diaz knows a thing or two about being a Judas.
4, 3, oh he's tapping! He's tapping! One, there we go, 20 seconds, I'm sorry.
20 second rest, Miano tapped out 2 seconds before time expired.
So there we are, we are 1-1 right now.
Well, I'll at least give Aaron Schaffner credit for calling that one accurately.
All righty.
The only thing he calls accurately
5,
in the whole match.
4, 3, 2, 1.
And we're down to the third period here, and it's tied 1-1. Next fall wins. There's still one more period after this if it goes to a draw, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm getting the rules. I'm starting to understand.
Yes. There are four, so it's...
Miano's going to go for Montezuma's curse here?
I think he is.
Big frog splash!
Nothing too fancy.
Yeah, that's very Chris Jones-like, that front splash.
Yeah, he's picking some things up, obviously. He's learned some things.
Yeah, all the wrong things, I'll tell you.
Oh, come on, come on. Ladies and gentlemen, there he is.
He should have learned from me. He'd have been XCW champion by now.
I think you're right.
I think I'm right, too. Maybe. I know I'm right. Maybe. Miana picking up ACT. Backing him into the corner. Remember, still one fall to one. Next fall wins. There's still one more 3-minute period following this if this goes to a draw.
It's been 1 minute, 2 minutes remaining.
And I would have to think draw favors the champion, but I have no idea considering, you know, who's refereeing.
Yep, it will go to a draw. The champion would retain.
Oh, my God. ACT is absolutely lighting up Miano Diaz right now.
Nobody wants to see a no contest, though, Eric.
I would think it would favor the champ, so I wouldn't mind. I would be okay with it, but I would rather it go to a natural finish, an actual finish.
In the event of a draw, the champion would retain, yes.
4.0 to Miano Diaz. He could have him here to retain the XCW title. No! 2 count only.
Close, but no cigar. We are approaching the 1 minute mark, ladies and gentlemen, and we are getting close here. But I will say the pinfalls have come in the last 15 seconds each round so far, so pay attention. 1 minute remaining, 1 minute remaining.
If we're gonna see anything happen, we're gonna see it here in this last minute. Big spring elbow, doesn't quite connect, but he got enough of it to stun him. And now taking him down with the shots, the kicks. And a big one to the back of the head.
Oh man, and Miano even goes down after that one as he goes for the pin.
There's a lot of force behind that kick. 1, 2, and no, ACT kicks out again.
Sir, 30 seconds left.
Much to Aaron's dismay.
30 seconds. Hey, Aaron can wait.
I don't think I noticed these things, but I noticed them. That's why I'm here, JJ. AJ, what is your name?
My name's RJ. Oh!
Springboard stunner by Miano Diaz.
Yes, sir. Ten seconds left. Be it.
Oh, no, he can't. Woo! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And there we go. That is it, ladies and gentlemen. One more round.
One more round to go. It is a tie game so far. One fall apiece. This is it. Last 3 minute round after this 20 second rest period. If Miano Diaz can't get it done here, you would have to think ACT would retain.
That is rough.
Aaron is an asshole. Look at this asshole. He's allowed to have a drink. Here.
ACT just needed
I stole this water bottle from Miano. You can have it.
High quality H2O leaking everywhere. He just needs some high quality H2O. And here we go. It's been 20 seconds. I apologize, a little slow on that one, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm just looking at this water bottle because I picked it up off the floor after Miano threw it. I think there's steroids in this.
Can you see the steroids in there?
I think there's steroids in this. Hold on.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let him have a little more than a break than necessary. My apologies there.
That's not water. I don't know what that is. Ew. Gross. Did Miano pee in this?
Oh man, Aaron getting wild over here.
Couldn't hit the hair. Come on.
It's okay.
He's a cheater.
Come on.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Ain't nobody would know about being a cheater more than Miano Diaz.
Come on, guys. Time limit.
Aaron helpfully reminding me too of the time limit. There's a little over 2 minutes left in the final period of this match.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2 minutes remaining in the contest.
And if Miano Diaz doesn't come out on top of this period, it will be Shark Week. Oh, my God.
I was about to say, stop saying period. Oh, my God.
And look at this. Come on.
His foot's on the rope.
Can we have a real official, please?
He is a real official, unfortunately.
Why is Chris Jones confused? He should be loving this. Oh, thank God. Good.
I guess once you've had enough.
To hell with Aaron Schaffner.
A minute and a half remaining.
There's no referee. There's no referee now. There wasn't really a referee to begin with, I'll be honest. But both men, now there's no ref. What is ACT?
I was going to say, he better get the ref.
ACT is calling for a referee. I mean, you knocked down the referee, to be fair.
Somebody wake him up, hit him!
There he is! Somebody had to wake Steve-O up.
Ref Steve-O to save the day.
Two, no!
Oh, no! He got it up in the six. Oh!
Just barely. Yep, that's Steve-O correct the taunt.
Steve-O! And there he goes. Oh, man, with 40 seconds remaining, not such a photo finish, ladies.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match.
Oh, wait, Ref Aaron, the belt!
I was the official assigned to this match. Not Steve-O. No. And I am perfectly capable of finishing it. So please, 3 more minutes back on the clock. We're redoing the last round.
I hate you.
Restart it.
What a dick.
Okay, well.
Hit it, Blade! Are you kidding me?
I thought that was going to be it for sure. Unfortunately for ACT, he's going to have to do it maybe one more time.
I thought I was going to have to kick Aaron in the face. Oh. He was coming a little too close to me.
Oh, there we go! Blade. That's got to be it. It's been 40 seconds.
Wait a minute, what? Zelina Nestle!
I don't like it.
Everybody in that ring can burn in fucking hell.
Wow. Well, Miano Diaz. We have the EBW Championship, and now they have the XCW Championship.
It's not a great day for America, boy.
Not at all. Not at all. I hate it. Oh my god, I just want to go home, I want to go to bed, I want to pretend like today never happened.
You know what, JJ, I'm done, I'm not giving this to Gravitas anymore. We'll see you guys at Hungry for Gold for JJ, I'm Eric Blackheart. Have a good night.
I'm looking like Johnny Dye.